In this question, you're going to use dimensional analysis, which is a tool we mentioned briefly in the unit, to do some basic analysis of two fairly advanced physics equations. Here we have E equals mc squared, one of Einstein's famous equations, which relates mass and energy. Energy isn't something we've talked about in class yet, but with dimensional analysis, you don't need to know what energy is to be able to quantify its units. And the way we did dimensional analysis was we realized we can write the units of just about any physical quantity in terms of mass, length, and time. So mass raised to some power, length to some power, and time to some power. So using your knowledge that m is a unit of mass and c is a unit of velocity or speed, you should be able to figure out what the units of energy are, even if you don't know what it is yet. That will be step one. But what I really want you to do, and what I want you to solve for this problem, I want you to tell me the units of this number h bar. And h bar is a number that shows up in quantum mechanics, which is a fascinating field of physics, all the time. So even if you have no idea what some of these symbols mean, there's actually still a lot you can learn about this equation. Let's take a look at this term, for example. Well, there's a lot going on in this term, but a lot of it doesn't affect the actual units of what's happening. So for example, I don't have to pay attention to this guy at all. This is the Greek letter psi, and it's dimensionless, so we can ignore it. These d's are just some instructions of some math to do, so actually we don't have to pay attention to those either. The negative sign doesn't really matter, and the 2 doesn't matter either. So what we're left with is this. This is the relevant part to this equation, unit-wise. Well, we have h bar squared over something with units of mass times x, which is length, squared. If we know that this whole term has units of energy, then what are the units of h bar? We know we can write it as mass to the something, L to the something, and T to the something. I've called those somethings A, B, and C. Enter in your answers here. One of the points of this problem is to show you that even with very complicated physics, there's some very simple analysis that we already have the tools to do. Now, if you're having trouble solving this one, don't worry. It's another tricky question. So, as always, go to the forums for help.